Okie dokie.
Aye.
Aye. Here's another one of my things I'm about to do. My little characters I just got through with it. I think I've got about 20. So I'm going to paint this one pretty fast. I've already got them pre-drawn. And I'm going to color it kind of like a watercolor effect with these acrylics. I'm going to try to explain how I'm doing this as I'm going on with this, but I probably won't even say anything. Okay, I have two buckets here. And my palette with my colors on it. And of course my picture. And since this is so small, since it's so little, I have to use my really, really tiny brushes. Alright, so I might talk during the process or I might not. Sometimes I don't because this is the first one I'm really actually talking. But I'm not. Alright, got my little character right here. Got him going and ready to be painted. So I go and get my brush. It's one of my fuzzled brushes. I normally got old brushes and everything. So first, I won't do it that way, because it'll kind of look the same. But okay, I'm gonna just go with a bigger brush, and I'm gonna try the blue. Watercolor effect. So I'm just gonna paint around. If the brush gets wet, not as wet, don't worry, just go ahead and use it and then tip it back in. And now I haven't sanded these boards. I just raw boards with gesso on it. I plan on sanding them after I get everything, all of them done and painted and everything. And then I'm going to sand them and put some clear coat on them and do it that way. Alright, the reason why I like to do the background first is just in case I get some of the paint on my character, I can easily paint it out. Okay, so got my character, and I got the two paintbrushes, two buckets, because somebody suggests that it's better to save it that way, so you don't have to worry about your brush being too red or not wet. Change not your water too much. And the reason why I have buckets is when I was in college, the professor always had a big gallon bucket in the room, the acrylic room that we had to paint from. And it wasn't just me who was painting from it. It was all the ones that were taking it. And there weren't very many people taking painting class. It was just us art majors and ones who wanted to audit the class. Alright, pretty much got them the way I want in the background. So it is a watercolor effect, so I just put the water in it. Alright, now I'm going to go ahead and get back. I may change brushes. Alright. So I'm going to get my brown. That's what I was going for, was an umber brown. Burnt umber. I mean, he gave us a whole bunch of colors that we're supposed to have and everything and what to use. And so anybody can go look those up. It's just that I'm going by, you already know this. And And so I'm painting home where I want it. Start off with a dark, solid color first, because it's easier. Now, I haven't decided if I want my blue belt, black belt, or any kind of belt, but, you know, he's doing his, he's in the middle of a pattern. And so I got that part. And now I have to figure out what hair I want him to have. I got rid of the red, so I don't have red. They want to have a blonde, so I'm going to go ahead and get my yellow ochre, and it's going to be like, kind of going to remind me of, kind of looks right now like my old teacher, my Taekwondo teacher, with his bright yellow hair. He really did. He had, that was the last one. He had bright yellow hair. And then, of course, he had a funny name. What's that to me? Real name. It's weird. And so I'm going to put the yellow hair and kind of dabbing it in there because it's a good way to. So I'm actually, I was more stenciling it. Now that we have that, I'm gonna get one of these script brushes. And then I have flesh tone portrait paint here. I'm mainly just trying to get rid of my paint because I got lots of it. And now I just go in and put where I want the light. And most of this is exaggerated lighting and exaggerating thing. I'm not really trying to make it be exact. I just wanted it to more be like a character anyway. And so I'm just, you know, just a little bit character caught in the middle of a pose for so I'm just dabbing. I'm, you know, just pretty much think as I'm doing it. Okay, wash my script brush out. Now, here's the fun part. The light. The, since most Taekwondo people in their dojos, they have to have white pants. So I'm gonna go in a little bit and kind of wash. Put in where I want. So it's background and him is gonna kind of be about the same color, but I can fix that, no problem. I know how to make it look different or not the same shade as the other. I've been trained in all experiments and stuff, so and of course I'm still going to use the watercolor effect. Alright, so we got, give me a little, some of this, turn to this side, so I'm going to add a little bit more darker. As far as I know, it's probably nothing recording on here because I'm probably talking really low and you won't be able to hear me. I'm mainly them just playing around today anyway. I have nothing else to do today, so I'm playing around. Characters, and it normally takes about the others took 9 to 10 minutes on them. They didn't really take all that long to do them. The color wise, I mean, I'm mainly just trying to get them all, you know, look like a watercolor effect. That's basically what I'm doing, is just watercolor and everything. These are going to be for sale if you want something different. It depends on what I'm going to do or not. But I was planning on not backing them and just, you know, put the poly coat on it and all that. Basically, just put the poly coat on and set after I sand them down and poly coat, and then that's pretty much it. Alright, here's the front card. I'm just about done. So I'm thinking about going ahead and doing the elbow. Just because I think it'll look a little better. And plus it'll tie in with his hair. And you don't necessarily have to be a yellow belt, a black belt to do martial arts. I mean, each one have a pattern that you can do. Add to it. This is good. Alright, now after I got that, some places I need to add a little bit more of this flesh tone. Of course, as it dries, it's going to get a wee bit darker. So to counteract that, I'm just going in just really, really lightly and add little highlights with white. This pattern. And of course, I have no face on them. The main reason why is it could be anybody. I have these little cartoon neck and everything. So, I'm going to go ahead and add white to the pants. Put little, like these pants look too slim a bit in some places. And now the last thing is always the last or next to last. This is a really, really tiny brush. I like to put my initials on it. Or at least the year 2017. And there, he's done. He's done. And if you give me just 1 second to get up there, I'm going to focus in on him a little bit. But less than what? 10 minutes? So we're less than 10 minutes here. Woo! And that's it. Oh, it's got 14. All right. Well, that's it. He's done. Ready to go. And this is it. this is it, and talk to y'all later, or maybe on the next one. He's a little bit longer than the others, a wee bit longer, but he's done, he's ready to rock and roll. Talk to you later.